Welcome back, South Africa.
Welcome back. It's Thirsty Thursdays.
We're almost there.
Yeah, we're almost there. One sleep.
It's quarter to the weekend, and we've got a delicious recipe to freshen up your Thursday. Our fresh milk handbag bread with a delicious cream cheese filling is an easy-to-make recipe for a light dinner or for that savory treat. And no, it's not meant to be placed in your handbag.
I know, but doesn't it? Isn't it beautiful?
I'm already thinking of things I can put in there.
I know. And then it's just like a handbag. It's like, thank going to chapel and I'm going to get married with my handbag.
Okay.
But you know what? There was this horrible bomb that exploded in Lebanon a few weeks ago in the harbour. And I was reading about the food then, and then I came across this beautiful bread that they sell on the street in Lebanon.
Okay.
So this is, and then they hang it on a wooden stick, and then they serve it with tartar inside or cream cheese inside, and that's why I decided to make it today.
Interesting. Okay, yeah. Please take us through it.
Yes, so first it's a bread dough. So it's a very simple bread dough. We're first going to mix, eat some milk, some of our Clover fresh milk.
In the blue bottle.
In the blue bottle, and this easy pour handle.
I love that, because at least now it means I can actually send my son to go fetch it and pour it for me.
Yeah, you can just go and buy the blue bottle.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
It's so easy to find, and you can just, it literally pops out at you.
I'm going to warm that up just to lukewarm water, not too hot. I'm going to add some yeast, because we need the yeast to activate.
Okay.
And then the food for the yeast is the sugar, we know that. Let me just loosen it up. And we're just going to leave that for a few seconds. I'm just going to give it a quick stir. And I'm actually going to put it down now again, because it's nearly tippet already. Okay. I know that. And then you just leave it somewhere to froth for about 10 minutes.
To foam up.
And then I'm going to mix it in my dough. But you are making a filling for
us. Yes. So the filling, as per your instruction, madam, we've got some cream cheese over here. We've got some basil and some Italian parsley. We've also got some garlic as well as some bacon that we've fried up, crisped it up, and then just chopped it nicely together. So I'm basically going to put all of this together. One thing I did do is we left our cream cheese out to soften up a bit, but I would like just a little bit.
A little bit of this milk, just to loosen it up, hey?
Because you can't really go wrong with Clover milk. I mean, it's been around for years, you know, and that basically means that it's a quality product that you can trust.
Yeah.
I used to have it when I was a kid. I'm still having Clover today, so it's withstood the test of time.
Yeah.
So I'm just
and it's delicious. You can buy cream cheese with that's already got the flavourings in, but I always prefer to put my own fresh herbs in.
Yeah, because you always just put another twist to it.
So this has been frothed up, not completely. You still have to wait. And then we're just going to add this to our flour. Mm-hmm. And we're going to mix it through properly. And you're going to knead it for 10 minutes. And I don't have the time to do that now. You knead it for 10 minutes, and then you let it stand and rise for the first rise to double in size. When you've done that, you come back, you knead it down again, and you let it rise again, double in size. But voila, we've got that whole process here. So the dough is finished. And this is a beautiful elastic dough. Look at that. The gluten has been developed. It's just a beautiful dough.
I have a trick up my sleeve, but we're going to first watch how you're going to do it.
Yes.
I'm also going to ask for a little bit of flour from you as well.
Okay. So first, I'm going to... You normally, the amount of dough that we've got on the website, and peeps, if you want the recipe, go to afternoonexpress.co.za. You divide it in four.
Yes.
So I'm just going to do one here. Oh, and I've got my favorite heavy, heavy rolling pin. So what you do is you just roll it out and you try and get like a teardrop shape.
Okay.
Let me just do that. So it takes a bit of time. Yes, it's so beautifully elastic.
Like, so it basically just follows you everywhere. When you go up, it goes up with you.
This rolling pin is amazing. You know, I've got a wooden one at home and I think I need to invest in this heavy marble one. So just try and get it in a shape like that.
Okay.
And I had a glass here. What happened to the glass? But I'm just going to use this now.
Okay.
Any round thing, just make the hole to form that part in there. Okay, like that, like so.
Okay.
And there it is, like that, South Africa.
There's your handbag.
And I'm going to put this handbag now on there. And then I'm going to brush it with a bit of Oh yeah, I need to add a bit of milk in. Yeah, you can just use milk, or you can use a bit of egg for some extra shine. Gonna add this. Quickly gonna brush this. I love working with dough. Bread is such a wonderful thing to do with family.
Yeah.
And it's so satisfactory, you know, to do. And it smells so nice.
Nothing beats home-baked bread. Like, I get there's all these other brands, but home-baked bread just has that inviting smell. It's just, it's amazing.
And then I'm going to add some sesame seed and bake that, guys. Look at this. You bake this in the oven for only about 10 minutes, 10, 12 minutes at 180 degrees, and that's it.
Awesome. You've got the one tip and the one way of doing it, and I went and found out that there's another way to do it. So you can basically just take the actual dough that you've got and roll out the ends so that the ends are thinner than the center. So this becomes the bag part, and then this...
Okay, so that will become the handbag, the strap part.
So these are the straps.
Be careful, just how the camera
is. This is why you must make sure you buy a quality bag, because it won't snap. And then you just basically keep rolling it out and leave the center hole. And then you combine these two.
Tombs.
And then you can just press it down so that the one side is thicker, the one side is basically...
You see, the children will love playing around with that. But Tombs, can I have some of that cream cheese?
Sure, definitely. And basically goes on, bakes exactly the same as yours, 190 degrees. And that is it.
So then everybody gets like a little handbag, and then you just cut it open like this.
These are like perfect party favors after you've had people over. Just stuff everything
with a glass of wine for me always.
Right?
And can you imagine, you've got this on the, you've got a handbag for everyone. I'm gonna grab the knife here. I'm gonna add this beautiful cheese that you've made. And you know what, Tombs, what I've kept on this week? We made that beautiful mince, that Turkish mince. So I've got some left here. And just to be naughty, I'm going to add a bit here at the top for a surprise for somebody. So people, never throw away your mints or anything that you've got in the in your fridge.
Yeah.
You know, just keep it for days like this. We're going to add some mints in here and a bit of more mints. And I've chopped some fresh herbs in there. I want to add more of your beautiful cream cheese to me. Look at this handbag. It's speaking to you. It's like, to me. Where are you?
Eat me.
Eat me. Eat me, Timmy. I think it's gorgeous. Look at that.
It is, and it looks divine. I cannot wait to try it. Now, that's one refreshing way to end a long day. To get your hands on this recipe, head over to afternoonexpress.co.za to indulge yourself in some handbag bread.
Yes.
Nothing beats the long-lasting freshness and quality taste of Clover Fresh Milk. Made with love by Clover.